Okay, so good morning. So today we'll start the new chapter, that is chapter number 4, colors in image and video processing. Okay. Now, what is the importance of color in image and video processing? Why color is so important? For what purpose color is used? More deep information you can get it. Okay. Anything else? For what purpose you need information in case of image and video processing? Yes. Why color is so important? Okay. Object recognition purpose. Okay. Object recognition purpose. Basically, here for object recognition or identification, there are some basic important features that we call as a low level features in case of image processing. Okay. Those low level features are, one is color, another one is texture, third one is shape. Okay. Color, texture and shape, these are the three important features for recognition or identification of the objects in the image and video processing. Okay. Out of that, color is considered as one of the important feature. Okay. Then another one is texture. Okay. So many objects are having a different kind of color, and we can recognize or perceive the color immediately, and human being also identify the object based on the color. Okay. Another one is shape, this one, texture. Okay. What is texture? When we can call that image as a textured image? Okay, give me example of texture image. Have you seen any texture image? Granite marble, okay. Very good. Simple one is your brick wall. This is a texture image. Okay. Why you are calling this as a texture? Why you call this as a textured image? Basically, here some of the information is repeated all over entire image. See that. This information, this one, is repeated all over entire image. This is called as a texel. Okay. And the whole image which is formed with this texel is called as textured image. Texture image. Okay. So, in real world, where you will find this texture image? See, in color, you can find everywhere color is there. Okay. What about texture? When you are doing the real world scene analysis, okay, where you will find the texture image? Okay, see, I said granite. Any other? Your shirt is also having one kind of texture, no? Horizontal pattern, vertical pattern. Okay. This curtain is having texture. Even your desk is having some kind of texture. Okay. Even if you go, okay, on seashore, and if you take the photograph of that seashore, okay, what kind of photograph you'll get? Small pebbles are repeated all entire that shisho. Okay. Or even if you take the photograph of this hair image, okay, you'll get the texture. This hair is repeated all over entire head. Okay. Or even if you take the photograph, this satellite image of jungle area, Okay, what do you get? These trees are repeated all over entire jungle. Okay, or even if you take the photograph of dam, okay, water is having some kind of texture which is repeated all over entire image. Okay, so in many real world images, texture is another or second important property considered. Okay, now if you use only color for object recognition, sometimes color may also get failed. Take example of tiger and cheetah. Okay, both are having same color now. Only thing is that texture is different. One is having stripes, another one is having dots. So if you use only color as a feature for recognition purpose, and then if you give a query as a tiger, there are chances that cheetah will also be retrieved, or it will be recognized as a tiger. Okay, so absolutely, yes, color adds beauty to the object, but texture is also one of the important property. But from human being point of view, okay, when you recognize the object, do you recognize the object mainly based on color or mainly based on texture or shape? Okay, it is absolutely shape. Okay, you might have seen that, okay, yesterday there was sad demise of cartoonist R.K. Lakshman. Okay, what he used to do is to draw the cartoon, and then cartoon with the help of shapes, no? With the help of only shape, no color, no texture. But we were able to recognize the who is that person or what kind of cartoon is there. So basically, a human being recognize the object, okay, strongly with the help of shape. Okay, but in real world application, okay, whatever the development has been done in the research of image processing or video processing, okay, many people, okay, got very good result with the help of color and texture, because they could extract the features with the help of color and texture efficiently, but they could not develop an efficient method which will represent the shape. So shape is considered a still challenging problem in pattern recognition or image processing or video processing or in content based image retrieval. Okay, so even if you consider the example of your retrieval search engine, okay, this search engines which are developed by IBM, that is Cubic, query by image content, okay, they developed this search engine for retrieving the similar kind of images from the huge image database, but their search engine is more successful with the help of color and texture, but when it comes with the shape, okay, that does not perform well. Why? What is the reason behind this one? The reason is that they could not, okay, extract the efficient shape features. If they can extract the efficient shape feature, definitely that will be more realistic, because human being as a layman, he doesn't know what is texture, what is color, but he knows shape. Okay, so there is a lot of scope for extracting the shape features and recognizing the object. Okay, out of that, now in this chapter we are going to study this color feature or color in the image. Okay, now how do you get the color? What is color basically? What is color? Frequency content? Is there any frequency with color? Okay, I think, okay, you know of this electromagnetic spectrum? Okay, now in that electromagnetic spectrum, okay, there is one visible spectrum. Okay, what is the wavelength of this visible spectrum? Hmm? 4000 watt. What? Okay, and in okay, in terms of nanometer, 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer is considered as a visible spectrum. Okay, below that one and above that one, it's not a visible spectrum. Okay. Now, this is the light theory basically. Now, as I told you in the last lecture also, okay, we perceive the color with the three basic primary colors. Okay. What are those? Red, green, and blue. Red, green, and blue. Okay. So in a visible spectrum also, okay, if you see, okay, I'm going to show you the power spectral density versus wavelength of red color, green color, and blue color. Okay. So the wavelength of, or basically this blue color is more dominant at which wavelength? Around 400 nanometer or 440 nanometer. Then green color is more dominant at 546 nanometer as per CIE standard. Okay. And red color is more dominant at in between 600 to 700 nanometer. Okay. So we perceive that color information. Okay, what happens basically? Definitely, a light from the source will fall on the object. Okay. And then object will reflect back that light, and then we perceive that light. Okay. So there are three concepts here. One is radiance, another one is luminance. Okay. And third one is related to your object. Okay. Now, what is by radiance? Where it comes? Is it related to your light source, or is it related to your the eyes? Light source. Basically, see that light from the source will fall on the object. Okay. So, radiance is defined as the amount of light. Okay, from the source falling on the object, and it is measured in the watt. Okay. Unit of radiance is watt. Okay. Then when it comes on the object, which property is there of the object? That is nothing but the reflectance. That is nothing but the reflectance. So definitely, okay, object is black. If object is black, okay. Now, when that light comes, okay, what kind of light it comes? Does it come a blue light, or does it come a green light, or red light, or it comes white light? It is a combination of all, okay. But now, okay, though see that this light is falling on me, it is white light. Okay, I think you perceive color. I also perceive color. Okay. Is how? This is a, though this is a white light. Okay. Basically, this object property is important, which reflects this light back. Okay. So if object is black, then whole light will be absorbed, and the reflectance will be minimum. Okay. And the reflected intensity will be minimum, and definitely whatever we are going to pursue with the help of, okay, how we are going to pursue it? With the help of eyes, no? Surely? Okay. Now, in our eyes, okay, as I told you, the part of eyes, human eye, okay. So, where this image will form? On the retina, okay. Now, this image which is formed will be a color image, or it will be a black and white image, okay. How this retina forms a color image? Because the retina consists of rods and cones. Okay, retina consists of rods and cones, means when light fall from the, okay, when right light radiates from the source, that is light source, that is nothing but the, this is nothing but the radiance, it is measured in watts, it will fall on the object, and then depend on the object how much light will be reflected and what color, what kind of color, okay, it will be absorbed by the your receiver. Okay, depends upon the object. Okay, so the amount of light intensity received by the receiver from the object is called as luminance. Okay, the amount of the light intensity received by the receiver from the object is called as luminance, and it is measured in lumen. Okay, so radiance is related to what? Light source. Luminance is related to what? Okay, receiver or human eye. Okay, or if you are considering, okay, capturing the artificial image, basically it will be a camera. Amount of light reflected back to the camera, and okay, whatever the recording will be done, that is, okay, is called as luminance. Okay, it is measured in lumen. Okay, so basically this light which is coming at the retina, it depends upon what? It depends upon the two factors, na? One is radiance and another one is reflectance, property of the object. Okay, so when it comes to the human eye, okay, it will be sensed by the, basically your retina consists of different rods and cones. Okay, now what is rod and what is cone? For what purpose cones are, or what is the responsibility of cone and what is the responsibility of rods? Okay, so particularly rod is active when light is minimum. Okay, means during night time. Okay, and cone is active when light is maximum. Now, how many, means basically this rod is responsible for getting the grayscale image, okay, whereas cones is responsible for, okay, obtaining the color image. Okay, how many cones are there in our human eye? There are 6 to 7 million cones are there in total. 6 to 7 million cones are there. Okay, what type of cones are there? There are some red cones, there are some green cones, and then there are some blue cones. Okay, so how many red cones are there, how many blue cones are there, how many green cones are there? Okay, so according to light theory, okay, you get the maximum response for the red, and after that green, and then minimum response to the blue. Okay, so according to the research, near about 65% cones are of red color. We sense red color. 65% cones in our human retina senses red color. Okay, 33% cones senses green color. Okay, and 2% cones, okay, senses blue color. Okay, 2%. Okay, so this is about the cones and rods. Now, the color model which we are going to study, okay, so how, what is the color model in the image? Do you know about the color models? Have you heard different color models? RGB color model is there, CMY is there, then okay, HSI is there, HSV is there, then LAB is there, YIQ is there, YCRCB is there. Okay, so there are so many color models. Okay, why so many color models? Why not only one color model? Why there are so many color models? And then which color model is used when? Okay, when can I use this color model, RGB color model, okay, CMY color model or HSI color model or like that? Okay, so basically these color models are mainly classified based on the two types. One is how human being perceives the color, and another one is okay, how hardware perceives the color. Okay, so one is hardware oriented and another one is human being oriented. Okay, so if you consider, here in case of hardware, where we generally represent the image or like that? See, on the screen you represent the image, okay, means monitor is there of computer. Okay, so for representing that image on the monitor of the computer, what kind of color model is used? Okay, and suppose for example if you print the image with the help of printer, what kind of color model is used? Okay, so one uses RGB, another one uses CMY. Okay, but how human being perceives the color? Does we consider, okay, perceive the color based on RGB model just because there are R cones, Z cones and B cones? Or we consider or we perceive the color by using another model, that is HSI. Okay, research says that human being perceives the color in HSI model, not in RGB model. Okay, so your intensity part is separated and chrominance part is also separated. Okay, so here HSI, what is this H? Hue. S is saturation and I is intensity. Okay, so this I is intensity part and chrominance part is hue and saturation. Okay, hue and saturation. Now, suppose for example, if I pass a white light through a prism, okay, what I'll get at the output? A band of how many colors? 7 different colors. Which are those? Okay. I think there is one short form for that one, na? Okay. I studied in Marathi, so I know that. Jata nahi pani pi. Okay. Now, all those colors are saturated color or unsaturated color? Or what is my saturation of the color? What is the meaning of saturation? Excess. Saturation means excess, na? You cannot go beyond that one. Okay, so all those 7 colors are purely saturated color. Purely saturated color. Okay, whereas means color where dominant wavelength is there. So that is called as the saturated color. Okay. Now, how we can reduce the saturation? How we can reduce the saturation of the color? By mixing white. So, for example, if you mix a white color with the red color, what you'll get? Pink. Okay, further white. Okay, it will be again pink and so on. Okay, so pink color is less saturated color or highly saturated color? Less saturated. Means, okay, the amount of white color, if it is increased, the saturation of that color will decrease. Okay. And color in its pure form is called as saturated color. Means, for example, if you draw the color model, RGB color model, what is this point? Black. Okay. What is this point? White. Okay. This one? Cyan. This one? Magenta. This one? Yellow. Okay. So, this color cube is a RGB color model. Okay. What do you think? At the vertices of that one, at the vertices of this color model, color is saturated? Yes or no? You cannot say every time yes, because white color is also there, na, at the. Okay. But most of the places it is saturated. It is in pure form. Okay, it is in pure form. Now, this one, the diagonal, if you join this one and this one, what is this? This is black point and this is white point. So, this will increase, okay, indicate what? This is nothing but the grayscale between the origin and the white white point. If you join that one, okay, that is nothing but the grayscale. So, it will start from 0, 0, 0 and then this will be 1, 1, 1. It is in normalized form. Okay. Otherwise, in 256, it will be 0 to 256. So, all those shades will be in between black and white will be there in that, this one. Okay. So, this RGB color model is used in monitor. Okay. CMY color model is used in printer, okay, because that is based on pigment theory. That is based on pigment theory. Now, what is that pigment theory and all those things that we'll study in the latter part of this one, okay. And then our human eye perceives the color in HSI model, okay, whereas in the television, okay, YIQ model is used for transmission and reception. Okay. YIQ is used. Okay. And in case of compression, image and video compression, YCRCB model is used for compressing the image or video. Okay. So this there are different ways of representing the color in the color model. Okay. Now see that how many colors you can represent with the help of RGB color model. How many shades will be there? 2^24. 2^24 different shades will be there. Okay. That is 16 million shades are there. Does it represent all the color shades? It does not represent all the color shades. Okay. So there is another model. Okay. Which represents more shades as compared to RGB, and that is nothing but the LAB color model, okay, or HSI color model, LAB, okay. And okay, that we'll see while studying the chromaticity diagram. What is meant by chromaticity diagram and all those things, okay? What about this one CMOI model? Does it represent all the color shades or less than that one? Less, okay, because for printing you don't need that many color shades. Okay, so and each point in that color model represents what? So for example, in this RGB color model, okay, every point inside this cube represents what? It represents the different shades. So there are 2^24 different shades in this color model. So in LAB there are more than 2^24 different shades. Okay, so that we'll study, okay, in the chromaticity diagram. What is meant by chromaticity diagram and all those things. Okay, and at the end of this chapter we'll study what are the applications of different color model, where we can use different color model. Okay, so light is an electromagnetic wave. Okay, its color is characterized by wavelength content of the light. Okay, laser light consists of a single wavelength. For example, Luby laser produces the bright scarlet red beam. Most light sources produce the contribution over many wavelengths, and visible wavelength, that is human cannot detect all lights, just contribution that fall in the visible wavelength. Okay, and this visible wavelength is ranging from blue to red. That is short wavelength produce the blue sensation, long wavelength produce the red one. Okay, so that is 400 nanometer is, okay, so this is the spectrometer. Okay, so device used to measure the visible light by reflecting light from a diffraction grating, okay, that spreads out the different wavelength. Okay, so this was the experiment done by Sir Isaac Newton. So this daylight or white light contains all the colors of the rainbow. Visible light is an electromagnetic wave in the range 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer. Okay. And this is represented as spectral power distribution, that is SPD, okay, versus wavelength. So this is the graph of SPD versus wavelength spectral power distribution of the daylight. As I told you that this human vision, okay, works is based on lens and retina. The eye works like as a camera, with the lens focusing on an image into a retina upside down and left right reverse, and then rods and cones. This retina consists of array of rods and three kinds of cones. The rods come into play when light levels are low, so during night time basically light level is low, and produce an image in a shades of gray. Okay, but if you create artificial light, then during night time also what will happen? You can sense the color. Otherwise how do you sense the object? Even if that person is wearing a colorful dress, okay, if there is no light, you'll see that one as a black object. Okay, because there is no sufficient light which can be sensed with the eye. Okay, so Here, rods and cones for higher light level, the cones each produce a signal. Because of their different pigments, the three kinds of cones are most sensitive to red, green and blue light. Okay? And it seems this eye brain system, it seems like that the brain makes use of difference, that is R minus G, G minus B and B minus R, as well as combining of all G, R, G, B into a high light level achromatic channel. So this is the spectral density, okay, or basically RGB cones and luminous efficiency curve V lambda. Okay, so this is the blue cone, response of blue cone, which is more dominant at 400 nanometer, whereas green one is dominant around 560 nanometer. Okay, and this red one is dominant. Okay, in between 600 to 700 nanometer. Okay, so this is the response, luminous efficiency curve response. Now, if you combine this one together, okay, you'll get a dotted curve, which is a combination of red, green, and blue. Okay, so this V curve is RGB cones and luminous efficiency curve P lambda. Okay, so this is the combination of all. Okay. So, luminous efficiency V lambda is the sum of response RGB, okay, 600 millions of cone are there, and then achromatic channel you get, and then the rod sensitivity curve looks like as a V lambda, okay, this power spectral density, okay, and as I told you that the spectral sensitivity function, okay, spectral sensitivity function is depending on what kind of cones, red cones, then green cone and blue cone. Okay, so this R color, okay, it is an integration of E lambda and Q R lambda, okay, D lambda. G is E lambda, integration of E lambda and Q G lambda, D lambda, and B is E lambda and Q B lambda. Okay, so definitely whatever the light intensity you have perceived in your retina, okay, according to that, neurons will fire in your, where is neuron? Where neurons are located? It is in, okay, in your retina, or it is in your brain? Brain. Okay, so there must be some connection between retina and brain, okay, and that connection is made by optic nerve. Okay, that connection is made by optic nerve. So electrical signals will be transmitted from retina to the brain through this optic nerve. Okay, so based on that, the amount of electric signal, okay, corresponding neurons will fire. Okay, so that this is the S lambda is the reflectance function. Okay, so reflectance function depends upon the color and this one. So this is the image formation model. Okay, so E lambda, okay, what is this one? Amount of light from the source, that is radiance. S lambda is, okay, reflectance, this one, and then C lambda is nothing but the color sensed by the human being. So this C lambda is a function of S lambda and E lambda. Okay, and this is further divided into three part. One is responsible for red, another one is responsible for green, and next one is responsible for blue one. Okay, so this is, so you get the color signal. So light from the illuminant with power spectral density E lambda incidence on the surface with surface spectral reflectance function S lambda is reflected and then is filtered by the eye cone function Q lambda. Q lambda is related to what? Basically our human eye. Okay, and S lambda is related to surface of the object, and E lambda is related to what? The amount of light coming from the source. Okay, So C lambda is called as the color signal, and it consists of the product of E lambda and the illuminant times, okay, illuminant, okay, times S lambda, the reflectance S lambda. So C lambda is equal to E lambda into S lambda, okay. C lambda is equal to E lambda into S lambda, okay. If you put it together, further classify this R, Z, B, okay. The equation that take into account the image formation model is that R is a integration of what? Integration of light coming from the source, reflectance, sensitivity, and then QR is a function of luminance. This is due to what? Red cones. QR is, okay, the response of red cones. Okay, S lambda is a function of surface reflectance, and E lambda is a amount of light falling from the source to the object. Okay. Similarly, see that E lambda and S lambda will remain same for all those R, Z, B. Only thing is that here it is going to change is QR, QZ and QB. Okay, so which is nothing but the function of your cones R, Z and B. Okay, so remaining part of this one we'll study tomorrow. Okay, we'll stop here.